factor, common factors, and grouping. So by learning how to factor out the binomial GCF, it prepared us for grouping. When we group, we're going to take the greatest common factor out of the first two terms, and then the greatest common factor out of the second group of two terms. And then we'll factor out the GCF, which is going to be a binomial, only if it matches. So let's take a look at our two examples here. We're going to break this up into two groups of two. Okay, so if I look at my first two terms, I notice that they both have a 5 in common and they have a y in common. So if I divide them both by 5y, it would leave me with a 3x and a 2. Now let's take a look at our second group of factors, or terms, I mean. We have negative for both of those, and so that means we're going to factor out a negative. And it looks like they have a 6 in common. So if I factor out a negative 6, I have 18 divided by negative 6, which would give me 3, and we have the x. And a negative 12 divided by a negative 6 is going to be a positive 2. These two binomials have to be the same in order to factor them out. So if I pull out a 3x plus 2, I'm going to be left with 5y minus 6. Okay, in example 2, again, I want to divide this into two groups. Notice where I put my division line. It's in front of the sign, not after the sign, because I want to make sure my signs don't get lost. If I look at my first two terms, it looks like we have a 3 in common as well as an x. And it'll just be 1 because my smallest exponent is 1. So if I divide 6 by 3, I get 2. X squared divided by x is x. Plus 3 divided by 3 is going to be 1. And x divided by x is just 1. And that's leave me with y. And here, I notice that my 2x plus y is the same as what I have there for my binomial. So that means my common factor here is going to be just 1, and I really want to write that so that when I take out my binomial common factor of the 2x plus y, then I don't, well, it actually just gives me a placeholder, and that's what I want it for. So I take out my binomial common factor of 2x plus y, and that's going to leave me with 3x plus 1. I have to have that 1, or otherwise, if I FOIL it back out to check my answer, I will not get this for my answer. So we're done.